Amanda, welcome to my channel. So this is the good, the bad, and the ugly, basically the best and the worst books that I read in the month of February. And there has been a lot of 4-star reads, a lot of very few 5-star reads, and some books, but there is one book in particular that sticks out in my mind that was pretty much the worst book that I've read. There was times whenever it was funny, but overall it was confusing. It made me had to think a lot, and it just wasn't my type of book. And that was called The Color of Magic by Terry Pratchett, and that is the first book in the Discworld series. Maybe I'm too stupid for it. I have no idea, but it's just definitely not my thing. I did read it all, and I did end up giving it 1 star, unfortunately. This was a book that was the book of the month that I do with my friend Brandy here on YouTube. We always do Beauty and the Books live every Friday at 9 o'clock Eastern Time, give or take a couple of minutes. And that was the book that was chosen. So I read it, and I read it in like a day. So it was really kind of no big deal, but I did have to take a break a few times because it just wasn't for me. If you guys enjoyed it, that's great. Now, out of 29 books that I read, there are quite a few that I do not remember, which tells me that they were just kind of average books. But there are some standouts that I do want to talk about, and one of them, actually two of them, is by Christina Loren, and this one is Dating You, Hating You that I finally got to, and this one is Love and Other Words, and these two are great, but if I was to pick one, man, I would probably pick Dating You, Hating You because I really enjoyed that, but I also love this one. I don't know. I don't think that I could pick one because they're both completely different stories. This one right here follows a girl who moves in. She loses her mother, and she goes ahead and they don't move. They just get a cottage over the weekend, and she meets this boy that is actually in her house when they go ahead and check it out and everything, and they become fast friends, and every weekend they spend together reading and everything, and it's just so cute. And it's just, they grow up together, and you just have to read it. It's so cute, and it even made me cry. I'm a sucker for this one. And this one, Dating You, Hating You, this one right here, actually, I don't even remember what it was about. Okay, yes, I do. I apologize. Again, maybe that just means that there was an average book, or maybe I just read too much. I don't know, but this one was really good now that I remember what it was about. There's this girl, and she goes to her friend's party, and she is an agent. And there is another agent there. She doesn't know that he's an agent, but they hit it off immediately. And then their companies merge. And when their companies merge, she sees him there. And they end up competing for the same job. And things kind of get put on hold between the two. And there's a lot of hate, a lot of things that they do to jeopardize each other's jobs, and it was just really cute. But let me just preface right now, let me just go ahead and rewind what I said and say, if I was to choose a book, I would choose Love, in other words, definitely. And the cool thing about this, whenever I opened this up to read this for the first time, I realized that it was signed. So definitely gonna end up displaying that because I love Christina Loren. That is a great duo. I don't think she could do any wrong, but it's not like I've read a whole bunch of books. Okay, moving on from Christina Loren, because you guys are probably thinking, my goodness, okay, move on, Amanda, move on. Okay, I do have to go ahead and check out my Goodreads to see everything that I read this month. So I can go ahead. The first one that I want to talk about is Vox. And Vox is so cool, and it is by Christina Doucher. And it's basically, you live in this society, in this country, and women can only speak a certain amount of words, and they are punished if they go over. And it's about one woman, pretty much, who doesn't believe it whenever they're talking about it becoming law, and she doesn't really do anything about it, and she kind of suffers the consequences of that, and whenever it's there, she's got to raise kids and everything else. And I know that a lot of people view this book as controversial, and a lot of people don't like it because it is Christian-based. Well, in a way, it's Christian-based as far as women are to be silent. But that is why I like it. I like it because of that. Because it is controversial, and it is another, it's another sect of Christianity. There are a lot of religions in today that are based upon women are to be seen and not heard. Same with children. So it kind of goes along with that. So if that doesn't bother you, then certainly go ahead and read it. I loved it. It bothers me that if this ever was to happen, well, I'm just going to run my mouth anyway. Forget the consequences. But I'm just saying, it was a really good book, even though it was controversial. The next one is Hate List, and that one was by Jennifer Brown. I've been wanting to read this book for so long, and I gave it 4 stars. And it's about this girl and her boyfriend, and she meets her boyfriend because he's always curious about what she's doing, and what she's doing is writing a list of things that she hates, or people that she hates, or situations that she hates in the school and in her life. And her boyfriend kind of takes that to a whole new level, and he shoots up the school and then kills himself. And she has to go ahead and pretty much say that she wasn't involved, and she has to convince her parents and everything else. And then it pretty much goes back and forth, taking place between before it happened, during it happened, and a year later, whenever she has to go back to school. Whenever she chooses to go back to school, and the problems that she faces when she is in the school. It's really, really interesting, and I really enjoyed it. Again, it's another controversial topic. It's something that's very sensitive and very real in today's terms, and I highly recommend it, definitely. Let's see. Another one is called A Killer's Mind, and that is by Mike Ulmer. I love this. If you think about the title, A Killer's Mind, this is pretty much what it's about. There is a killer on the loose, and it's just, and you really get to learn how twisted this guy is, and you don't know who it is. You go through the whole process of suspecting who it is. It was just really, really good, and I also gave it 4 stars, and I definitely want to read another book by Mike Ulmer. I'm excited to read another book by Mike Ulmer, so maybe he's going to be an author for me. I don't really know. I can't really judge it by one book. But if it's anything like this one, definitely want to go ahead and get it. I'm a sucker for serial killer books. The next one is 5 stars. And I'm sorry to say this, but it also is by Christina Loren. This was a Christina Loren month. And The Honeymooners was something that I got through NetGalley. And oh my God, I absolutely loved it. It's about these two sisters. They're twins. And one of them has really, really good luck, and the other one has really, really bad luck. That's the way it's been all their life. And she, the one with the good luck, is about to get married and gonna have the perfect wedding. I mean, this girl, she wins everything, all the contests, so she has this elaborate wedding, and it's pretty cheap. And everybody ends up getting sick. And because everybody ends up getting sick, her sister ends up telling her that she needs to be the one to go to the honeymoon, because there's no way that she can get her money back. And so she ends up going with her sister's husband's brother, and they despise each other. So here they are on her sister's honeymoon, and it's just, I absolutely loved it. And then of course, after they get back, there's a lot of issues that needs to be dealt with, and a lot of things are learned, and I loved it from beginning to end. It hooked me. 5 stars, definitely. So whenever it comes out, I highly recommend it. I don't know whenever it comes out, but I highly recommend that you read that. Let's see, what is another one? Let's see, I this another book that I do want to kind of talk about is The Gentleman's Guide of Vice and Virtue. I forgot about this one for a minute. I gave it 2 stars. I was not a fan of it. I don't know. I'm guessing that that book was just not for me. I was really hoping to love it, but I just simply didn't. I don't really have an explanation for it. I just didn't like it. I also managed to get caught up on the Nikki Heat series by Richard Castle, and there isn't one more book that is coming out, and I range these books pretty much between 3 and 4 stars. If you are a fan of the show Castle, I highly recommend them, but they're really nothing special, but I really enjoyed it. I really enjoy sometimes like detective novels, cop novels, things like that, and I was just in the mood for them, so I'm glad that I was able to actually catch up this month. Let's see, another one is Stillhouse Lake, books 1 and books 2. I am surprised at how much I loved this book. I gave them both 4 stars, I think. Yeah, I gave them both 4 stars, and they are by Rachel Kane. And these books are just, oh my God. I can't even really put it into words. There's this mother and her children, and they are escaping her husband and the father of her kids. She comes home one day and there is an accident right in front of her house. They go ahead and they bust right into the garage, and the cops are there, and as soon as she gets in there, the cops go ahead and arrest her, and she's absolutely confused and baffled as to why. And lo and behold, she finds out that in the garage that she never goes to, because that's basically her husband's man cave, she finds out that her husband is a serial killer. So it's all about what she's going through and escaping, and running from the situation and changing her name. And both books are phenomenal, and hopefully in March I will read the third book, which I also have for review, so I can't wait for that. Another one is The Iron Flower, and that is the second book in the Black Witch Chronicles. I read the first one and I was absolutely hooked. Now, I did give this 5 stars, but I do have to say pretty much about 25% of the book was political, and I'm not very big on political books. I don't like it whenever there's a whole bunch of different types of groups of people. You've got the Fae, you've got the wolves, you've got the witches, you've got this and you've got that, and they all have their own beliefs in the political system, so that was just kind of hard to follow. But after you kind of get past that and into the story, it's really, really good. And let's be honest here, we find out in the second book who the Black Witch is. Now, I did get this on NetGalley, and it's one of those books that was kind of sitting there, and I feel awful about it, but it did just sit there. But I did finally read it, and NetGalley is just amazing. If you guys have not tried NetGalley, you really should, because it's great to get review books. The next book is The Past and Other Things That Should Stay Buried by Sean David Hutchinson. I gave this 4 stars. I almost gave this 5 stars, but the character development wasn't enough for me to make it 5 stars, if that makes any sense. But I absolutely love this book. There's a girl that passes away, and it is this boy's ex-best friend, and she comes back from the dead. And it's really good. It's really good, and there's not really much that I could say about it. I did listen to this on audio the day that it came out, and I'm thrilled. It was a really quick read, or really quick listen, I should say. So definitely go ahead and check that out. The next one is called The Ungrateful Dead, and that is by Rose Cooper. I gave this one 5 stars. This was one of those books that I got from Book Outlet whenever they had that sale, and I was so pleasantly surprised by this. There's a girl that found a cell phone, I'm assuming, in the first one, because this one was the second book, And dead people start to text her, and she sees ghosts, and she helps them, basically. And it leads her to have a very interesting life. And there is one girl that passes away, and she finds a way to come back and basically is a zombie. So it was just really cute. And I really want to read the first one. And one day I'm definitely going to read the first one. I can't find it anywhere. And I think it's called I Text Dead People. I know ThriftBooks has it, but I haven't placed an order yet. So whenever I do, I hope that they have it. I know Amazon has it, but ThriftBooks is cheaper. And I'm cheap. So there you go. Another 5-star read for me is A Serial Killer's Daughter, My Story of Faith, Love, and Overcoming by Carrie Rawson. This was written by the BTK Killer's Daughter. I did get this for review and instantly picked it up, especially after I read the People Magazine article. And all I could say is 5 stars all around. And I loved hearing her perspective, or reading her perspective on things, as the daughter of having basically the rug pulled out from under her, learning who her dad is, who her dad truly is, and her path to forgiveness, and how she was affected, and how her family was affected. And it's a phenomenal read. So I highly, highly recommend it, especially if you guys like true crime. But this is so much more than just true crime. This is about her journey to forgiveness, and it was a really cool perspective, and I recommend it all around. I cried a couple times. It was very touching, and I feel so bad for her. That's all I can say. I just feel so bad for her. The next one that I read that was also 5 stars, you guys are probably going to laugh at me, but it is called The Boss Baby, and it is by Marla Fries. And I love the cartoon, the movie, and I love the Netflix series. So yeah, I had to. It was only 40 pages, but I had to get it. And I just had to. And it was the cutest book ever. And I recommend it to anybody who's got little kids, or anybody that loves Boss Baby in general. Definitely. Not much more I could really say about that. And then the next book that I want to talk about is Pecan Pies and Dead Guys. It is part of the Southern Ghost Hunter Mysteries. It's the 7th book by Angie Fox. My goodness. And this is the first book that I read in this series. And the first book in the series, at least as of yesterday, was free through Amazon for Kindle. So if you guys are interested in that, definitely go ahead and check it out. Basically, it's like a cozy mystery with some ghost hunting. And it's great because this girl, she goes ahead and she sees dead people. And it's just, I loved it. And another series right now that I am reading, again for NetGalley, like the Pecan Pies and Dead Guys was also for NetGalley, is the Charlie Davidson series by Dorinda Jones. And I have been reading the first 5 books, so I need to start the 6th book. And that is a really good series if you haven't watched it already. She is basically, I don't want to say what she is because that would be giving it away. It's supernatural, it's paranormal, it's awesome, and you definitely need to read it. And I know the last book is out and I have it on hold, but I definitely plan on reading the rest of the series. Hopefully in March I will be able to finish the series. We will see. They're definitely fun, quick reads. And so yeah, that was a mouthful. So many books that I've read this month, and it's kind of hard to just bring it down to just a few. I did skip some, obviously, but that was pretty much my most enjoyable month that I've had reading in a very long time, because pretty much every single book was great in some kind of capacity. And it's just, I hope that you guys take some recommendations from this and maybe enjoy some new books. Or if you guys have read these, let me know how you felt about them. And my goodness, if you guys have read The Color of Magic, explain it to me, because I don't understand I just don't understand. So let me know what your favorite book has been for the month of February and what your least favorite book has been for the month of February. So I know this was a little bit of a long video, but hey, what can I say? I'm a reader and it happens. It's probably not going to happen like that again, but you never know. So I hope to see you guys next time. Be sure to like, comment, and subscribe, and I will see you guys next time. Bye!